Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.
Where has this Ashutosh Gowariker been for so long? Heck, where has this Arjun Kapoor been forever? Hey guys, my name is Sucharita, this is Film Companion. You are watching Not A Movie Review. And right now, I am not going to be reviewing Panipat, The Great Betrayal. This is the story of the Maratha Empire at the height of its political might. Almost pure desh mein phaila hua ye samrajy bataur peshwa chala rahe the Nana Sahib, played in this film by an extremely fit looking Monish Bell. Under the peshwa, his cousin Sadashiv Bhau, along with a group of Mard Marathas, they undertake various battles to solidify this empire, the most notable being the 1761 Battle of Panipat, which unfortunately ended in disaster for the Marathas. This film is not set as grandly and as deeply designed as a Sanjay Leela Bhansali movie, but that's okay because you can sense vintage Ashutosh Gowariker making an appearance here and there, especially in the choreography, music and editing of the song Mard Maratha, a war cry of sorts, reminiscent of Bar Bar Haan from Lagan, lots of men singing and dancing in unison, ready for battle. Kafi cool. The Bhansali comparisons might not be entirely fair, lekin puri tarah ignore nahi kiya ja sakte. Kyunki in a manner of speaking, ye Bajirao Mastani ki continuation mein hai na story. Monish Bell plays Bajirao and Kashibai's son, Arjun Kapoor is Bajirao's nephew, aur ek do dialogues mein Mastani ka bhi mention hai. How funny would it be agar Shanivar Wada ke diwaron pe poster lagao the Ranveer Singh, Deepika Padukone, Priyanka Chopra. No, thankfully that does not happen. And Ashutosh Gowariker focuses more on the politics of the Maratha Empire rather than the love stories of the kings and the queens. And the political story becomes the flavour of the film, which makes the storytelling easier to consume because a well-documented historical timeline rukai. With CGI maps used liberally, the narrative seems tight and easy to follow, which is an achievement. Because itna kuch ho raha hai is film mein, raita phailne ka scope was very very high, jo nahi hua. But you know what is very very high? The Hinduness of it all. Shivling ke close-up shots, Shiv ke gaane hain, constant exaggerated shouts of Har Har Mahadev. It's too much. Ek scene mein military formation ka drone shot upar se aise dikhta hai, it's like the head of Ganesh. To really drive the message home, the purity of the Hindus is shown by well sunlit sabhas, tilak, pujas. Jiske comparison mein Afghans ke jo rooms hain, unki sabhaen jo hain, they are lit by firelight. गुफा जैसे सेट्स हैं जहां दो चीजें सबसे ज्यादा प्रोमिनेंट आपको दिखाई दे रही है, खूब सारी मीट, सो एज टू से कि ये मांस मच्छी खाते हैं ना इसलिए वायलेंट है, और दूसरी चीज है खंजर ही खंजर. इट्स नॉट सटल बट इट्स इफेक्टिव एंड ड्राइव्स आशुतोष गोवारिकर्स पॉइंट होम इमीडिएटली. अच्छा, क्योंकि फटाफट मूवी की पेस मूव हो रही है टू बिल्ड अप टू द बैटल, इस किस्म के सेट डिजाइन को एक बार सही से एस्टैब्लिश करके दोबारा एम्फसाइज नहीं किया गया, थैंकफुली. द थर्ड बैटल ऑफ पानीपत इज हिस्टोरिक फॉर मेनी रीजंस, फॉर द नेवर हर्ड ऑफ बिफोर बैटल फॉर्मेशंस, द ह्यूज नंबर ऑफ पीपल हु डाइड, द फैक्ट दैट मोस्ट मराठा सोल्जर्स वर फाइटिंग ऑन एन एम्प्टी स्टमक, वन ऑफ द रीजंस अट्रिब्यूटेड टू देयर लॉस. ऑल दिस film also shows you, lekin for some reason forgets to really amplify the great betrayal it mentions in its title, never making it quite clear or certain ki kaun se betrayal ki baat ho rahi hai. Also, the battle sequences feel thoda humdrum kyunki jis scale aur historical importance ki ye ladai thi, that needed a larger, more ornate canvas to be satisfactorily portrayed in the same style in which the rest of the film has been mounted. It also very conveniently forgets the many mistakes made by Sadashiv Bhau before launching into this battle. Kafi literature hai uske bare mein online padhiyega. Kyunki Sadashiv bilkul hi pure light ke bane hue hain aur aasman se utre hue angel jaise dikhaya gaya hai. Character ki layering khatam ho gayi. And despite a rather wonderful and mighty sincere Arjun Kapoor performance, yeah, you don't feel a whole lot of allegiance to Sadashiv because as a human being he doesn't seem relatable. But Arjun Kapoor, please, more of this, less Chetan Bhagat. Okay? Kriti Sanon in a career best performance is a revelation. Going from chirpy to cheeky to angry to sad with ease and picking up a sword when in desperate need, but not seeming like a trained sword fighter at all because she's actually a Vaidya. It's a scene stealing performance and she really stands out in the cast. Sanjay Dutt, while he looks the part, occupying the screen, hulking, hunched shoulders, jaise ki he's constantly ready to punch your goddamn teeth out, seems to be sleepwalking through his part and doesn't quite enter the skin of the legend that is Amateur Abdali. In one scene, he kills a man by hitting him repeatedly with the Kohinoor diamond. Maybe this is supposed to show excessive decadence, ki the biggest diamond in the world is with him and it's of no meaning. But all I could think of was, what? The Kohinoor was in Afghanistan? India kaise aaya? How did the Queen Victoria get her hands on it then? Shout out to Mantra for infusing the evil Najibuddaula with an almost comical selfishness and lack of grace. An acting choice which works really well. One of the best moments of the film though is awarded to Zeenath Aman in a cameo. It's a very tender scene between her and Kriti Sanon, who has gone to this lonesome queen, Sakina, played by Zeenath, to ask for rations kyunki Sena bhookhi mar rahi hai in the middle of nowhere. Zeenath looks with her small sad eyes towards a painting of her dead husband and says, "Jang to mardon ke ahem." A moment Ashutosh Gowariker uses very cleverly, or maybe I'm reading too much into it, but he tries to comment on the futility of all that he spent all this time putting together and showing ki eventually none of this matters. None of this bloodshed would have happened if these men had just checked their egos. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Panipat is two scenes pure Milind Gunaji gets. In one, he's singing, in one, he's dead. I wonder if the part was longer and they cut it short. PP&W ka NAMR dekhne ke liye FC ko subscribe kare. JMD.